Thank you very much, Salim. Let me say how lucky you are that are not wearing a tie. And let me say that I'm going to fulfill with your request to have a very spontaneous reaction.
Excellent.
To the question. So I'm not sure who can put my PowerPoint. No, I'm just kidding. let me reflect by moving around some concepts. During the preparation of this COP20, I've used to say that for us, what the climate debate means and the decision that Peru has made to bring the climate debate into Peru, it is to create information, sufficient information, that are going to create awareness that we are suffering a problem. And with that two first, we are going to raise ambition. And with the third one, we are going to move the action. I think that that is key. That four, information, awareness, ambition, and action. So to try to deal with your three questions, let me say that for me, the key word, it is recognition. First, recognition of the role of the science. That is a very important topic, and I saw it in the first phrase. This is a process in which we had recognized before of the 92 Climate Change Convention the role of the science, even in a time in which the science was not completely sure that it has been a human source or the human fault, this problem of the emission. But after that, in some time, we have begun to divorce the decisions of what the science are saying to us. Fortunately, we are again reconciling our decision with the science. And probably it is not only because we are more aware of what it is happening, but also because the science, it is more able to transmit their message in a more simple way. And that is very important. Because I'm not sure how many of you have already read the IPCC report that has been released in November the 2nd in Copenhagen, and also the summary for decision makers that has shown to us not only the trend, the threat, but the policy and political options. That is very important. So the second recognition item, it is the recognition of vulnerability. So it is not only vulnerability because our economic activities. It is vulnerability, I'm used to saying that we should recognize that there are a natural vulnerability, for example, in case of Peru, the glacier melting, the change of temperatures in ocean, the water scarcity, among some others. But there are a material vulnerability. It is the concept that it is related more to poverty. So the poor people, it is going to suffer more the consequences of the climate change. So we do need to recognize why we are vulnerable. What does it mean, the glacier melting for a campesino who has these small lands to have potato crops? What does it mean for the indigenous peoples who live in the Amazon basin that are suffering not only the conditions of poverty, but now the consequences of the climate change? My third reflection around the recognition concept, it is, we are in a very interesting time. We are, I think, in the most interesting time of our history, of my 50 years, of the last 50 years. Because probably it has been because of the financial and economic crisis of North America and Europe. It has been because of the ideological debate after the Wall of Berlin fell. It is because some other issues that we have begun to felt that in the concept of sustainable development, there is an opportunity to change the paradigm of development. And it is interesting that now, in this time, 2014, we are discussing all this climate debate that includes the national contribution that are going to be our programs and plans for the future. So we are going to put on the table our programs to mitigate emissions and also to adapt it, our economic activities, our human, our population, our infrastructure, to make it resilient to the climate change. But on the other hand, we are also discussing SDGs, And I recommend to all of you to read the first draft of the SDGs with the 17 topics and with the, all the metric that I hope by the next year we are going to adopt. And we are going to complement it, the SDGs, with the post-2015 ODMs. No, ODMs is in Spanish. What is it? In English it is? SDGs, yeah. The Millennium Goals. With the Millennium Goals, sorry. So that is the second piece of this development discussion. And the third one, it is around the strategies of green economy. The world is discussing the green economy strategies that I hope that make us able to continue our growing, a very good economic performance, but including the consideration to the natural infrastructure, to the social conditions, to the decent and green labor conditions, and to the clean technologies adoption. So that's three pieces, the climate debate, the SDGs with the objetivos, with the Millennium Goals, and the green economy are three pieces of the same, the new paradigm of development. We know that we are changing the paradigm. Through that three glasses, we are going to have in the next 30 years a new world with new concepts and with new approaches. And also, what we do need it is to integrate that discussion in our domestic reality, to make it possible to be sure that we are going to have into consideration the conditions that are creating poverty. It is the only way to connect our domestic reality with the global debate. That is why I'm very optimistic of this current debate, because we are in a situation in which we, fortunately, we have not had what we had suffered before of the Copenhagen COP in 2009. Because we are in a time in which we are discussing how to balance the bottom-up reality with the top-down decision. And that is good, because we are trying to get an agreement based on the consideration of what it is, the political reality, the domestic reality, the economic and the social reality of the countries. And that is good, because we do need to recognize that the world, it is not a very stable place in which nothing happened. The world is like this, with a lot of geopolitical situation, also earthquake, as what Japan had suffered some years ago. So I think that that is also key, because by recognizing what it is our domestic reality, we are going to deal also with the condition of poverty. And let me finish saying that we do need to work strongly in our adaptation agenda. Adaptation, it is more than just a term. Adaptation does mean something that we need to know exactly. We need to go deeply to try to identify what are we referring when we talk about adaptation. Because if we want to have a strong debate on adaptation, we need to create some metric, some very clear concepts, some very clear measures, as the only way to try to create a global agreement that strengthens the adaptation concept. And adaptation, it is key to fight against the poverty. Yeah. So I hope that with these ideas, I have fulfilled with your request to react to your question. Thank you very much.
You have indeed, Minister. Thank you very much. And in fact, your last remarks on adaptation, very close to my heart. I've been spending 20 years working on adaptation, and I hope that Lima will actually leave us a legacy on adaptation. Let's not wait for Paris. Let's do it here in Lima and have a Lima agreement on adaptation that we can all be proud of. Thank you very much.